Hi, I'm Rosalind Nashashibi, and I'm here in my show Hooks at Nottingham Contemporary.
The title of the show, Hooks, came about quite early on in my process of making this work. And it was both a literal reference to hooks. I'd just been in France where there were these shutters with hooks, and I was started to paint hooks that kind of connect to one another, but also I like the idea of hooks because I think of when I look at a painting or hear a song, I think of the thing that draws me in that I can't necessarily explain or articulate as a hook. I started with this motif of the shutters and the hooks, and I also returned to some motifs that I'd used earlier and combined them. So I've done quite a few paintings where you can see, you either look between the lower part of legs, or somebody's looking back at you through legs, or in this case also through shutters, and a woman in one instance looking through a fan, in another looking through eyeglasses. So this sense of a kind of filter that you look through, or a barrier that you look through. So this was some of the hooks I started with, and I also, you know, some of them came from just mundane things in real life, such as these metal hooks, and others came from other paintings, such as a Manet painting of Bert Morisot looking through a fan, which I've painted in 2020, and I've again painted another version for this exhibition. So it's directly referencing Manet's painting, but it's my own invention, if you like. And yeah, as you walk through the exhibition, you'll see how one motif kind of grows into another, I think. I went to see a show of late Monet, Water Lilies, and Joan Mitchell. Those two painters' practices came also quite influential in the last works I made for this show. You can see a quotation of the Water Lilies, see this kind of rush of paint across one canvas. I'm just fed by other painters' work, and I allow it to influence me. And I think my practice is really about allowing myself to move through the things that interest me. Some of the paintings, and maybe particularly those two Malvolio paintings, in both cases there's a woman who's looking from behind through the legs, and in one case she's looking through a fan, another one she's looking through eyeglasses, and there's a sense of the woman inspecting. The man is sort of just in a fragment, these two lower legs, and the woman's sort of inspecting from behind. So there's a sort of humour in that. And this painting that's beside me, the composition of this work comes from an earlier painting that I did, which is also in the show. Both works started with a composition that came from an uccello painting, which is a predella, which is a long piece at the bottom of an altarpiece. And it tells quite a horrific story, told across the long painting, and each part is bracketed by red pillars. And I've used those red pillars that uccello used a few times in various paintings, because they give a parenthesis, they give a framing, and I'm really interested in framing in my work. And so in this painting, the pillars became these golden colored curtains. And I also used this sort of sectioning of the canvas into parts, which here is a seascape. And then I brought this aspect of a graffiti in a way onto the work. I wanted to see whether this could work as a sort of, in a way you're looking almost, are you looking at glass which has a graffito on it, or are you seeing something emerge up from the sea? And there's a sort of wicked joyfulness about this little demon with this sum. And the title I give this painting is Joyous Recognition. A smile rises up from the deep. If I try to talk about the difference between my practice as a painter and my practice as a filmmaker, the experience is utterly different, because I'm painting every day in the studio as much as I can, and filmmaking has got a very sort of on and off rhythm. It takes time to get to the, you know, a lot of time to get to the point of shooting, which is very collaborative and really about channeling an experience that I'm having in real time and trying to capture something. In this sense, it's like painting. And but another long gap, and then editing, you know, and then it comes around again. So it's kind of, there's a lot of different speeds. And I think what's interesting for me now as a painter, apart from the work that I'm doing and how that feeds me, is having a daily practice in which I'm learning very quickly, in a sense. And I don't mean learning so much skills or techniques, I mean learning the kind of painter that I am and want to be.